Hello, my dear girls and boys, a very warm good evening to all of you once again, and thank you very much for staying tuned so far. And we have moved towards the last topic for this chapter, that is ethical issues related to biotechnology. जो इतना भी हम recombinant DNA technology या genetic modification कर रहे हैं, so there are some issues which needs to be addressed, and that we will be discussing in today's class. And here I have Preeti and Pallavi. All so good evening to all of you, and Yogesh again. So a special thanks to those who are continuing from the last class, okay? And those who are watching it on YouTube, please do come on our web page in order to interact with me. Agar aapse ko mere saath interact karna hai, to please do come on our web page. Now let's see what we have done in the last class. Just so we have talked about the medical diagnosis, so there I have explained ki ELISA, PCR, how these techniques can be used as a tool for a molecular diagnosis. And then we have also talked about the transgenic animals, so what are transgenic animals, what are some of their examples, and how you should be looking into this topic. Ye sari kahani jo hai humne pichli class mein hi padha hai. Aur jo CPP aapko diya gaya hai, if you have just solved the CPP question, so the question which I would like to ask all of you is, ट्रांसजेनिक मॉडल एग्जिस्ट फॉर, ट्रांसजेनिक मॉडल किन किन के लिए एग्जिस्ट करता है? रूमेटॉइड आर्थराइटिस, सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस, कैंसर, अल्जाइमर्स. सो ए 1, 2 एंड 3, बी 1 एंड 3, सी 1 एंड 2, एंड डी 1, 2, 3 एंड 4. सो वॉट विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर? सो ट्रांसजेनिक मॉडल्स वेन वी टॉक अबाउट इट एग्जिस्ट फॉर ऑल ऑफ देम. सो दिस इज द आंसर विल बी डी, दैट इज 1, 2, 3 एंड 4. So this is a direct question from the lines of your NCERT. आपके NCERT के line से ही ये question बनाया गया है, and this is how the questions will be framed. Okay. So in today's class we will be talking about the ethical issues in biotechnology. Biopatent क्या है, what is biopiracy, and then bio war, and then stem cell therapy. So these are the topics which we will be covering in this particular class. इसी class में हम देखेंगे. ओके, सो मुझे मालूम है जो लोग ए बोल रहे हो, इन दैट केस यू आर कंफ्यूजिंग बिटवीन ट्रांसजेनिक एनिमल्स एंड ट्रांसजेनिक मॉडल्स. ठीक है, सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन देम. ट्रांसजेनिक एनिमल्स आर द एनिमल्स व्हिच आर ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड एंड दे हैव द फॉरेन जीन इन देम, एंड दे दीज जीन्स कैन प्रोड्यूस द डिजायर्ड प्रोटीन इन देम. मॉडल्स इन अदर हैंड कैन बी, दे आर नॉट ऑलवेज द ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड एनिमल्स, दे कैन बी मॉडल्स टू टेस्ट द effect of a particular drug related to a particular disease. So they are called the transgenic models. ठीक है, and transgenic models are available for all of them. Is that clear, Yogesh, Sakshi and Preeti? Clear है ये चीज? A क्यों नहीं होगा उसका answer? तो पहला है ethical issues. So see, when these done because genetically modify, you are modifying an organism, whether it is plant or animal, we are genetically modifying it to synthesize the products of our desire, or in order to get the characteristics of our desire. ठीक है, so in this case this can be even misused for forming something else, or so in order to check that misuse of the genetic modification, we need some rules, regulation and an authority to check that. And in case of India, the Indian government has set up organizations such as GEAC. तो ये बहुत ही सिंपल सा है, but GEAC का फुल फॉर्म याद रखना है, जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग अप्रूवल कमिटी. सो वॉट इज GEAC? इट इज जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग अप्रूवल कमिटी विच विल मेक डिसीजन रिगार्डिंग द वैलिडिटी ऑफ GM रिसर्च एंड द सेफ्टी ऑफ इंट्रोड्यूसिंग GM ऑर्गेनिजम्स फॉर पब्लिक सर्विसेज. क्योंकि जो जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म है, बी इट प्लांट और एनिमल, इफ इट इज नॉट प्रॉपरली सेफ टेस्टेड और on different parameters, in some cases it can be harmful also. कि genetically modified है, अब क्या है कि instead of serving the purpose, it may cause some other harm to the human race, right? So in that case, in case of India, it is GEAC, that is genetic engineering approval committee. और genetic engineering approval committee का काम क्या है? It looks after, takes decision regarding the genetic modification researches and the safety of introducing. अगर कोई एक genetically organism है, उसको जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म है, अगर उसे हमें पब्लिक डोमेन में इंट्रोड्यूस करना है और इट नीड्स टू बी इंट्रोड्यूस इन पब्लिक सर्विसेज, इट चेक्स फॉर दी पैरामीटर्स दैट वेदर इट इज फिट टू बी इंट्रोड्यूस फॉर ह्यूमन यूज और नॉट. फाइन. नाउ हियर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ GEAC के काम क्या है और ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है, उन किन किन चीजों का ध्यान रखती है. फर्स्ट इज टू परमिट द यूज ऑफ जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड देयर प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर कमर्शियल एप्लीकेशन. ठीक है, ऐसे ही किसी ने भी कुछ भी बना दिया, इट कैन नॉट गो फॉर कमर्शियल एप्लीकेशन और इन पब्लिक सर्विसेज, दैट नीड्स एन अप्रूवल फ्रॉम द GEAC इफ इट इज रिलेटेड टू जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म. अगर ये कोई जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म का केस है, बी इट प्लांट और एनिमल, वी नीड परमिशन फ्रॉम GEAC, दैट इज जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग अप्रूवल कमिटी. नेक्स्ट इज टू अडॉप्ट प्रोसीजर्स फॉर रेस्ट्रिक्शन प्रोडक्शन स्केल इम्पोर्ट एक्सपोर्ट एप्लीकेशन ऑफ GM organisms. और जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड, जहाँ पे भी GM है दैट इज जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड. सो टू अडॉप्ट प्रोसीजर्स फॉर रेस्ट्रिक्शन, जितने कौन सा प्रोसेस लाइक टेक्निक्स भी है व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रोसीजर्स ऑन विच देर हैज टू बी सम रेस्ट्रिक्शन, बनाना है या नहीं बनाना है, वेदर द प्रोडक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड, वॉट शुड बी द अमाउंट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, इम्पोर्ट वाइज वॉट whether any genetically modified organism should be imported or not, or export के लिए भी जा रहा है. So it puts check on everything. ये सारे parameters जो हैं from starting to end, it is checked by the GEAC. Or it takes decisions for that. To approve or conduct a large scale field trials and release transgenic crops. अगर transgenic crops भी है तो उसको directly ऐसे ही, हाँ अब अच्छा बन गया, अब seeds दे दो farmer को, ऐसा नहीं होता है. We need to test this and उस test को करने के लिए we need approval from GEAC. और approval किस type का होगा, to conduct large scale field trials. तो small patches में field पे हम large scale trial करते हैं, not across the country. Field trials will be there and for these field trials the approval comes from the GEAC. ठीक है, GEAC ही वो authority है जो इसका approval देती है. Next is to authorize agencies or persons to have large scale production and release of genetically modified organisms. ठीक है, अगर agencies है या person है, उनको अगर किसी भी type का approval चाहिए, so I have this, suppose an organization comes up with a statement कि हमें पास ये genetically modified crop है, so shall we go for its large scale production or can we release it, so the permission comes from the GEAC, right? So these were the functions of GEAC. Now we are into the next topic, that is biopatent. So a patent is the right granted by a government to an inventor to prevent others from making commercial use of his invention. ठीक है, तो इसका मतलब क्या, अगर किसी ने कोई चीज को invent किया, whatever it is, in terms of when we are talking about the biopatent in case of biotechnology, यहाँ जब हम बात करें, so we are talking about the plants and animals. ठीक है, but patent can be for anything, for any invention, and if it is unique to the person, the patent rights can be granted so that others cannot use his or her invention without giving credit to them. Now patents are granted for biological entities for products derived from biological resources. ठीक है, so patent grant होते हैं biological products के लिए भी, and biopatent is important because see if there is a variety which is developed by the scientists of a country, या हमारे scientists ही द्वारा हो, or it's very indigenous to our country, anything of that kind, so if patent rights are there, so there are many benefits which the organization or the country gets when you have the patent rights. You can get the information on the product, it will be written. If it is a genetically modified thing, you will have the description on the product that it is approved by the committee or not. ठीक है, जैसे food के लिए भी है FSSAI approved, there will be tags on, अगर आपने देखा होगा, if you have seen Yogesh, the packets which we bring from markets, right? तो वहां पे approval रहता है. But whether it's a food or if it is genetically modified, the whatever the concerned authority is there, that will be mentioned in the product details, the what are the approvals are available, or what are the available approvals the product has. Now other than this is bio patent when invention is there. Agar kisi ne invent kiya usko aapne patent de diya. But then in bio or in case of genetically modified organisms also, in case of the plants and animals also, there is piracy. So what is biopiracy? It is a term used to refer to the use of bioresources by multinational companies and other organizations without proper authorization from the countries and people concerned, without compensatory payment. Because when something is indigenous to a place, or it is suppose if someone has its patent right, so if I have patent for anything XYZ, right? So if someone else wants to use that product, they need to pay me the compensation, or they need my permission. Theek hai? Without doing that, if they do that, in this case the person can sue them. But if there are multinational companies or organizations which do not take into consideration the country from which the particular patent or particular, suppose in case of basmati rice that we will be talking about, so that is indigenous of India, but it is being used and the patent is given to some other country, so now the farmers of our country is facing problems. So these are the problems associated with biopiracy. So when the products belonging to a particular country or is used by someone else without taking the authorization or without paying the compensatory अमाउंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड बायोपायरेसी. ठीक है, उसको हम क्या कहते हैं, बायोपायरेसी. सो इन 1997 एन अमेरिकन कंपनी गॉट पेटेंट राइट्स ऑन बासमती राइस थ्रू द यूएस पेटेंट एंड ट्रेडमार्क ऑफिस. दिस अलाउड द कंपनी टू सेल अ न्यू वैरायटी ऑफ बासमती इन यूएस एंड अब्रॉड. दिस न्यू वैरायटी ऑफ बासमती हैड एक्चुअली बीन डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम इंडियन फार्मर्स वैरायटीज. An Indian basmati was crossed with semi-dwarf varieties and claimed as an invention or novelty. तो कैसे क्या है, जो इंडियन बासमती की वेराइटी है उसको सेमी ड्वार्फ वेराइटी से क्रॉस करके एक छोटा सा नया वेराइटी बना दिया. एंड इट वॉज सेड इट इज ऑल न्यू थिंग एंड द पेटेंट राइट इज गिवन टू देम, राइट. एंड नाउ इफ आर ओन पीपल और आर ओन फार्मर्स वॉन्ट टू यूज इट, वी नीड द परमिशन. सो दैट्स द प्रॉब्लम विच पीपल फेस ड्यू टू बायो piracy, and this is an example which happened with India itself. So, and rice in India, we have n number of varieties, registered varieties are there, and which needs to be patented. Otherwise, kya hoga ki it will be used by someone else only. And there, in case of this patent right which was given to the American company, there the system is ki any new thing introduced in their country is new to them, and whosoever introduces it, they will get the patent. But that is not justified, and it is not very judicial for the other person from where it has actually come. Like here, the basmati actually belongs to India, right? So that these are the some of the problems related to biopiracy. Or यहाँ पे जो important चीज़ है जो basmati rice है, then in your book there are the numbers, exact figures. What are the different varieties? So that number is important. You should remember, and then which type of company it was. So these are important points. So ये जो biopiracy case, that too of basmati rice, this has been asked. It has already been asked for 2-3 times, or कभी भी कहीं भी पूछा जा सकता है, तो इसको आप याद कर लीजिए. ठीक है, नाउ वी हैव बायो वॉर. सो इन केस ऑफ बायो वॉर और बायोलॉजिकल वॉर और बायो टेररिज्म इज द डिप्लॉयमेंट ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल वेपन्स अगेंस्ट पीपल एंड देयर क्रॉप्स एंड देयर एनिमल्स. ये बायोलॉजिकल वेपन्स कैसे हो सकते हैं, इट कैन बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ एनी वायरस बैक्टीरिया और फंगस प्रोटेक्टेड इन कंटेनर्स एंड दैट विल बी रिलीज ऑन द एनिमी साइड. तो वाई एंड दिस वेपन्स आर कॉल्ड बायो वेपन्स. सो इट कैन टारगेट द एनिमल्स, सपोज इफ इट इज ऑफ एर्सिनिया पेस्टिस द प्लेग. ठीक है, सो दैट विल कॉज प्लेग इन दैट एरिया. और it can be any fungus or bacteria which is infecting, which will infect the crops of the people. So crop agar infect ho jayega, so food will not be available. So these are the various techniques by which the people will try to make their enemy weak. But use of bio weapon is not very ethical, because you are using the microorganisms for spreading diseases or killing the crops or animals. And in this case we can use the pathogen against the human beings. That's the one bioweapon, or the toxins. ठीक है, the toxins produced by the pathogen. So directly the toxin can be released. So that is the toxins we can use. Then we have the anti-crop agents. So anti-crop agents, it can be the pathogens which will cause diseases or which will cause the crop failure. Crop failure के लिए जो pathogens responsible होंगे, that can be used. And that's why this kind of a war will be called as bio war, because here we are not using any guns or ammunitions. It is all biology. Okay, the pathogens or toxins or anti-crop agents. So that is what we mean by bio war. Right, so now on your screen will come the first question for the class, and here it is, and please do answer the question. Now select the correct statement. GEAC takes such issues into consideration, including patent terms, emergency provisions, and research and development initiative. The Indian Parliament has recently cleared the second amendment of the Indian Patents Bill, which makes decisions regarding the validity of GM research. See, transgenic model exists for many human diseases such as cystic fibrosis, Alzheimer's disease, cancers, and rheumatoid arthritis. D, all of the above. So, in me se kaun sa sahi statement hai aapko batana hai. And these are lines from your book, exact lines. So that's how the questions will be framed. क्योंकि ये chapter क्या है, थोड़ा सा theoretical है. We feel like it's all paragraph, but it is not like that, right? So what will be the correct answer? Hurry up. One, okay. Pallavi says 1D. Yogesh bhi D bol rahe hain. So actually the answer is C. Dekho, what will happen? GEAC has the rights. ठीक है. So the decision regarding the validity of GM research is with GEAC. Okay, and the Indian Parliament has the second amendment hai, that is for the patent terms and emergency provisions and research and development initiative. So the lines are exchanged. Okay, so that's why A and B are incorrect and C is the correct answer. So Sakshi, very good. And now I think Pallavi, Yogesh, Preeti and Peru, it's clear that the D is not the answer. C will be the answer. So this paragraph as such in book is also like that. Aise hi hai ki lagta hai ki sab sahi hi hai. Right, the way we have just studied GEAC, so this will also go in that patent terms emergency right, to hoga. So that is very, so that's why it is important that you should read your book very properly. Theek hai, apne book ko acche se padho, because that from there the questions can be framed in n number of ways. Theek hai. Okay, Peru, I was waiting for you. So the last class, the question, please, I have explained that. So please do see that question again. If you still have the doubt, I will take the question in the next class also. ठीक है? Because there I have explained that you have to take into consideration the probe where it is hybridizing, and based on that only you will get the two different bands. Now on your screen will come the second question for the class, and here it is. The term used to refer the use of bioresources by multinational companies and other organizations without proper authorization from the countries and people concerned without compensatory payment is. Abhi ye paragraph was there on one of my slide, but in black ink. So that was the only difference. So you should answer this by the time I read out all the options. A, bio prospecting, B, biopiracy, C, biofortification, D, bioinformatics. Pallavish says it's B. What is the term used for the... Okay, so Preeti, Sakshi, everyone says B, and the time is up, so majority must be granted. It's B. The term which is used, so biopiracy is nothing but it is the use of bioresources by multinational companies or other organization without proper authorization from the countries and the concerned and people concerned without compensatory payment. Isko hum kya bolte hai? Biopiracy. Theek hai? And very good, Pallavi, Preeti, Sakshi, Yogesh and Peru. This is the question I've asked in the last class. So the question was, name the first transgenic variety of tomato to reach the market. So it is Flavor Saver. Theek hai? Answer kya tha? Flavor Saver, and the first person to answer it correctly was Preeti Baghel. Theek hai, Preeti? Congratulations, clap, clap, clap for you, and you will get your free atom session credited by the end of this class. And almost all of you were writing pomato. So pomato is a cross between potato and tomato, and the question is asking about variety of tomato. So it's flavor saver, it has higher shelf life uski zyada hai. Why it is so, I've already explained. Okay, so it's just for ऑप्शन देने के लिए दे दिया हमने वो. ठीक है प्रीति. ओके सो एंड नाउ ऑन योर स्क्रीन विल कम द टुडेज कॉन्टेस्ट क्वेश्चन. फॉर दिस क्लास द कॉन्टेस्ट क्वेश्चन विल नाउ कम ऑन योर स्क्रीन एंड हियर इट इज. Change. So answer to today's contest question I'll explain you in the next class along with the name of the winner, right? And now on your screen is the next topic for the class, that is stem cell therapy. So what are stem cells? Stem cells basically. So stem cells aise cells hote hain, they are cells which have the capacity to give rise to any kind of cell of your body. Theek hai? And provided the environment, like the stem cells which are taken from your bone marrow, if at that stage we say they have the capacity to give rise to all the different types of blood cells of your body. But at the same time there are stem cells, like if it is embryonic stem cell, so embryonic stem cells have the potency, okay, and this capacity to give rise to all the different kinds of cells of a person's body or of an organism, be it plant or animal, it is called totipotency. Theek hai, to a cell having that potential is called as totipotent, and these cells can be used as stem cell. And in case of stem cell therapy, if these cells are preserved, suppose your embryonic stem cells are preserved during the developmental stage itself, your parents have preserved the stem cells, right? So now how that can be used, because I remember a few days back, like last year or so, that the advertisements for stem cell preservation was very frequent, was zyada the stem cell preservation ke. So where it can be used, that I will explain. So regardless of their source from where they are taken, all stem cells differ from other cell types. Other cell types means the cells which are already mature. Stem cells are on the other hand, they have the capacity to give rise to all the cells. Whereas other cells, suppose if I say a cell of your retina or a cell, a liver cell, a fully matured liver cell, they are very specified. So there can be different sources of stem cell. It can be embryonic stem cell ya fir aapka bone marrow cell hai. Sources can be different, but they have a few following general properties. Unme kya properties? The first is stem cells are unspecialized, undifferentiated. That is, they do not have any tissue specific structure. That is the reason they can, provided the condition, agar aap sahi molecules or hormones provide karo, they can give rise to any cell of your body. Why? Because they are unspecialized, undifferentiated. So these cells are not yet specialized. Unko malum nahi hai unko kya karna hai. So that they can be guided to, unko kya karna hai. They can be guided to become whatever we want. Theek hai? Whereas other cells which are specialized, agar specialized cell hai ya differentiated cell hai, they are very tissue specific. Unko malum hai unko wahi kaam karna hai. Say for example, if it is neuron, they know what to do. Theek hai? Ki signal conduction hai. So that is very very specialized cell. Cells of your retina or any specific cells, cardiac tissue. So they are very specialized, they are differentiated. Unko malum hai wo kya karna hai. So in this case it will be reversal from differentiated to undifferentiated, and that is why stem cells are preferred, because they are unspecialized. So provided the environment, whatever you give, this can be guided to become any other cell of the body. I didn't get your question, Peru. Pallavi, I've already answered. That was just to make an option. Okay? Or in other words, if you go by the literal meaning of, so for what are the different prospects of a particular thing, that can be done, right? But that was there just to make the option over there. Is that clear, Pallavi? I didn't get your question, Peru, so can you please clarify your question? Now, next is, they are capable of renewing themselves through cells division for long periods. That is, they replicate many times, and this process is called proliferation. Proliferation ka matlab hai cell division, cell proliferate ho raha hai, toh number increase ho raha hai. Like, see, when we talk about meristematic cells in case of plant, jo meristematic cells hote hai, unka kaam kya hota hai? It's only to divide. So the, when the cell is only dividing and it is not maturing, so they keep their amount, or they are capable of renewing themselves. And inside the body also, the stem cell which is there in your bone marrow, or those cells, if it is a stem cell, what it will do is, it can, once it divides, suppose it is divided into two other cells, so one will remain the stem cell, other will be, this is the stem cell, and then other will get mature. Okay? So, well, detailed answer Yogesh has given. So, that's what I said, the prospecting, go by the literal meaning of the word. So, prospecting is the, when you have the places where a particular thing can be used, whether it is a plant or animals. When we talk about medicines, it can be medicinal or the drug. So, that's the kisi bhi cheez ka prospect kiya hai, the future, right? And then we have the next thing. The stem cells which is there, they can be induced under certain physiological experimental conditions to become cells with specialized functions, such as muscle cell, skin cell, nerve cell, blood cell, etc. And this process is called differentiation, right? And this is the property of stem cells which is exploited in case of stem cell therapy. Stem cell therapy mein hum is property ko use karte hain. How this is used? Suppose if the embryonic stem cells of a person were preserved. Now, imagine the person has a very rare blood group. Uska blood group bahut hi rare tha, and something happens. So, suppose it requires a blood transfusion. So, in that case, whenever blood transfusion is required, generally the doctors will go for the siblings. Okay, aapke bhai bahan hone se, that is the preferred donor. If they are not there, then anything else will be seen. But if your stem cells are preserved, from those stem cells, the blood cells can be formed, because as I have said, you have, these cells have the capacity to become any other cell of your body. Stem cells ke paas kya hai? Wo capacity hai ki wo dusri cells ban sakte hain, provided we give the physiological conditions, right? So in that case, if the embryonic stem cells were preserved, the red blood cells or the blood cells of the person's own body can be made. And these cells, because they were their own embryonic cell, it will be exactly as the person's cell. So there won't be any chances of any kind of reactions or allergies. Okay? So there won't be any problem. And yes, people are looking into the prospects if we can develop a complete organ. If we are able to do that, that will be another level in medical science, because if with the help of stem cell, if we can make the organs, those organs will never have the problem of graft rejection. Okay, so this is what is done in case of stem cell, what we mean by stem cell therapy. So with the use of the stem cells, if the physiological conditions are provided, whatever cell we need, that can be made and the person can be treated, right? And provided the stem cells are of his or her own, okay, wo stem cells aapka apna hona chahiye, then only this therapy can be used. I hope this is clear. What is stem cell therapy? In case of plants, okay, you are saying plants. Okay, plants, you have the meristematic cells, Peru. So that can be used. And in case of plants, it is easy to de-differentiate and then re-differentiate. So callus culture, the tissue culture which we have studied in the, that even any part of the plant you can take, it is de-differentiated and then that can be re-differentiated. Right? So the cells, it is easy to manipulate the plant cells. But in case of the animal cells, or more specifically the human cells if we talk, so in that, if we take any very specialized cell, it is difficult to de-differentiate and make them stem cell and then again remake it, right? So that is why in case of human models or animal models, we will prefer the stem cells or the cells which have the potential to become any other cell and they are unspecialized. Is that clear, Peru? So, Sakshi, I have just answered the question, I hope. So, Peru and Sakshi, is the explanation clear or you want me to explain it further? So, now on your screen will come the next question for the class and here it is, and answer this question. Select the incorrect statement. A. For the effective treatment of a disease, early diagnosis and understanding its pathophysiology is very important. B. Over 95% of all existing transgenic animals are mice. C. Antigens are chemically protein, glycoproteins, etc. D. None of the above. Okay, thank you, Sakshi, Peru. Sakshi and Peru. Last 5 seconds, which one of the following statement is incorrect? And your time is up. So let's look into the options. For effective treatment of a disease, early diagnosis and understanding of its pathophysiology is very important. Isme kuch galat hai hi nahi. It is actually, if early diagnosis is there, or pathophysiology, you know, the pathogen's physiology. How the pathogen life cycle, like malaria ka malaria life cycle, if we know it clearly, it is very important to treat the disease. So this is a correct statement. Over 95% of all existing transgenic animals are mice. This is also correct. Antigens are chemically proteins or glycoproteins. Generally, yes, it can be protein, glycoproteins, and because etc. word is there, so jitne other groups hain, wo bhi aa jayenge. So the answer will be D, that is none of the above, because the question is asking which one is incorrect. Incorrect option kaun sa hai, so all of them are correct. Is that clear? And one more thing, if you are very clear that A and C is correct, so even if you do not know the figure, sometimes in questions aisa aa jayega 95%, 80%, 60%. So it's not necessary that you will remember the exact percentage, but whenever there is marking only one thing, like incorrect statement is there, but you know that two questions, statements are correct, so go for none of them are incorrect. Okay, yeah, all are correct. This type ka option hoga. Is that clear, everyone? And good, Sakshi. Now on your screen will come fourth question for the class, and it's a lengthy question. I'll give you some extra time, but please do answer it correctly and put your brain into that. Sodium chloride is harmful to most crop plants. A scientist at the University of Toronto genetically modified a plant so that it could be grown in dry parts of the world where the available water has a high level of sodium chloride, NaCl. This genetically modified plant copes with the high levels of NaCl by transporting salts into its vacuoles, where it accumulates to abnormally high levels. Which feature would be observed in genetically modified plant when compared to non-modified plant? ठीक है, तो इसमें जो modified plant है, non-modified plant है, उसमें क्या difference होगा? A. The leaves in the modified plants are more yellow in color. B. The modified plant has salt crystals on the surface of the leaves. C. The cytosol. The cytosol is the material between the plasma membrane and the vacuole membrane, excluding the organelles, in the modified plant has lower osmotic pressure. And D. The cytosol in the modified plant has higher osmotic pressure. So which of the following will be correct? Hello Anandu, and I didn't get your question. Anandu, can you repeat your question? What specifically you want to know about NEET? So what will be the correct answer to this? Pallavi says it is D. So let's look into the question now. देखो क्वेश्चन क्या बोल रहा है इट्स अ स्टोरी ठीक है यहाँ तक तो पूरा स्टोरी बताया NaCl हार्मफुल है एक नया मॉडिफाइड प्लान बनाया है व्हाट इज द जिस्ट वी हैव टू प्लांट्स वन इज मॉडिफाइड वन इज नॉन मॉडिफाइड इन केस ऑफ मॉडिफाइड प्लांट्स इट हैज द कैपेसिटी सो इफ इट्स अ प्लांट सेल यू हैव द वैक्यूल्स हियर सो इनसाइड द वैक्यूल द सॉल्ट गेट्स एक्यूमुलेटेड ओके सो हाई सॉल्ट कंसेंट्रेशन से इट कैन अडैप्ट इन केस ऑफ नॉन मॉडिफाइड प्लांट इट विल नॉट बी देयर So what will be the difference? The leaves in the modified plant will be more yellow. Why? Is it affecting the amount of chlorophyll? No. B. The modified plant has salt crystals on surface of the leaves. Why will it have? As per question, it is saying it is accumulating in the vacuoles. Okay, and vacuoles is present inside the cell. So why the salt crystals will come on the surface of the leaf? Then the cytosol in the modified plant has lower osmotic pressure. And next is higher osmotic pressure. तो अगर cytosol का osmotic pressure low होगा, water moves from low osmotic pressure to high osmotic pressure, right? But here in this case, since the salt is accumulated in vacuole, the osmotic pressure of the cytosol will be higher and not lower. ठीक है, low नहीं होगा, इसका osmotic pressure जो है, it will be high. Is that clear to all of you? And good Pallavi and Peru and Sakshi. Yogesh, is that clear why the answer will be D and not C? Now on your screen will come the fifth question for the class and here it is. The nucleic acid extracted from animal liver is loaded and run on agarose gel. Nucleic acid को हमने extract भी कर लिया है animal liver से and उसको run भी कर दिया है. After staining, it shows the following pattern. So this is the A pattern shown after staining and if the remaining sample to agar run karne ke baad jo sample bacha tha if that sample is treated with RNAs and loaded in gel what result would you expect A B C and D so you have this is the original gel electrophoresis results and then after treating with RNAs what will happen which kind of band pattern you will get And your time is up. The nucleic acid extracted from the animal liver is loaded and run on agarose gel. After staining, so okay, Pallavi says it's A. The answer will be A. So after staining, it shows the following pattern. So what it will be? And in this case, see what it is talking about. जब हम nucleic acid ले रहे हैं, ठीक है? We have taken all the nucleic acid. Nucleic acid will include DNA and RNA. So first we need to understand why this band pattern has come. ये band pattern क्यों आया है? This band pattern has come because DNA and RNA we know both are negatively charged, ठीक है? And they both will move towards the positive side. But RNA being lighter, RNA ज्यादा हल्का होगा, DNA is double stranded, it moves farther and DNA will be closer, थोड़ा धीरे move करेगा and that's why we have this band pattern. Now if this remaining sample is treated with RNAs, so RNAs is the enzyme which will cleave the RNA molecule in the sample. RNA molecules को क्या करेगा? Cleave कर देगा, degrade कर देगा. So as a result of this, we will get the sample where we have just the DNA. So we know the first position is of DNA. RNA क्या है? It is cleaved. So in all these cases, A represents the condition because here we have the DNA. This is the location of the well where nucleic acid was loaded and there is no band for the RNA. So is that clear why the answer will be A and not D? Pero that is possible for other plants, salt crystals jama ho jayenge, but as per question you have to look that there is a modified plant, there is non-modified plant, so what will happen? So that way you have to answer, because there it is not mentioned any specific name of the plant. If the name of the plant was mentioned, we could have answered the last question, that is sodium chloride question, based on the example which you are saying. Is that clear? So the answer for this question is A. Is the question clear to everyone? Why this band pattern has come and why the answer is A and not B, C or D? Okay. So with this, thank you Yogesh and Sakshi. So okay, this is clear. So with this we have come to an end of this class. So to summarize, we have done what are the ethical issues related. The important thing is what is GEAC, uska kaam kya hai, the objectives of GEAC. What is biopatent, biopiracy, example of basmati rice is important. The figures of your NCRT, like how many varieties are there for rice in India, out of them, how many of them are registered. So those figures are important. And then we have talked about what is biowar and stem cell therapy, right? So with this, we have come to an end of this class. So thank you all for joining in. And just in case I have missed any question, because in between there were many questions. So in case I have missed any question to answer, I will answer you in the next class. And now you will get the CPP to practice, or it is the class practice pack time. So in the class practice pack, you will get 10 questions to practice based on the topic that we have discussed. Please do solve the questions, right? And in order to get the access to the class practice packs, you need the access to passport membership. So please do subscribe to passport membership, which will give you the access to the class practice packs. Along with that, you will also get access to 24/7 one-on-one doubt solving sessions, access to practice questions and tests from best-selling books, and access to all the video classes covering the toughest concepts and problems. Okay. So on this note, I take your leave. Good night, Shubhratri, Shabakhair, and do take very good care of yourself. But passport users, do not go anywhere. Start solving the question right away. Good luck.